communication with Southern California, KHJ-TV Public Affairs presents Prime Time. And now your hosts, Fran Allison and Tony Lamb.
Hello again, Prime Time people. Tony Lamb and I are very excited today because we have a program which we think will not only be very pleasant to view, but highly informative as well, particularly for senior citizens.
And also for the younger persons who love and care for seniors.
Oh, of course, Tony.
Now, we have with us Dr. Joseph Novello. He wears so many hats, I want to be sure to get this right. He's a practicing psychiatrist. He is an author. He's a columnist. He's a television medical correspondent in Washington, D.C., and he's here to discuss the problems of aging and how to deal with them.
And the lady who will be accompanying Dr. Novello on this nationwide tour to bring a most inspiring message to our senior citizens is one of the most beloved, the most popular of all stars in motion picture history. She's Miss Alice Faye.
The snow is snowing, the wind is blowing.
And Tony and I will be right back after these announcements.
What do I care how much it may storm? I've got my love. Let's go slumming. Take me slumming. Let's go slumming on Park Avenue.
Well, you could not mistake that voice. Alice Faye had one hit after another, one hit picture after another. Meet her now, Alice Faye Harris. We're so glad to have
you here.
Thank
you, Fran. It's so nice to see you again.
And the gentleman with whom she's touring, Dr. Joseph Novello.
Thank you, Tony. It's a pleasure for me to be here with Alice and with the two of you.
Yeah, how did you two happen to get together for this tour?
Well, Dr. Novello and I are going out on a lecture tour funded by Pfizer Pharmaceuticals. It's a public service. And we're going to be talking to lots of senior citizens, I hope a lot of my old friends.
I hope so, too.
About maintaining a better life and being responsible for themselves. And all kinds of goodies.
We prepared some lectures and some tips for seniors, and Alice is an inspiration to, I'm learning from her as we go along about this, and that's the sort of thing that we'll be doing.
Well, Tony will be talking with you, Dr. Novello, and going into a little greater detail, but I would like to get an update on Alice. Alice, you look so lovely, and as I told you, we're so happy to have you here. You're such a wonderful model for senior citizens.
Thank you.
I know that you began your career in the 30s, and I think with Rudy Valley, am I correct
on
that?
Uh-huh. I sang with his band.
And then, of course, when you went into pictures, you had a procession of the top leading men in the industry.
Wonderful. Tyrone Power, Donna Meachie,
yes,
John Payne. Go on and on and on.
You could indeed. Yeah. And then after your marriage to Phil Harris, and I must tell you that I've been in love with him for years.
Oh, really?
Still am. Well, he's such a great performer. Well, after you did marry Phil, you virtually retired. You didn't really, but you didn't do a great deal in films after that. You did in radio with him.
Yes, we did.
Well,
you've been very busy, though, raising your family and then community affairs in Palm Springs.
And raising Phil, you know.
Yeah. Raising Phil is something in itself.
So they're all raised now, so here I am.
But you have, as Tony said, been very active in community affairs in Palm Springs, where I think you live most of the time.
That's our only home, Palm Springs.
Well, and then you never really retired. And Tony admires someone of that nature, because you haven't retired, and I suppose you never will.
Fran, I retired 5 times.
Well, someday you'll get it right if you just keep at it. Well, the two of you are certainly a wonderful duo, a famed celebrity, a prominent physician, and sharing your experiences with the people that you will be meeting throughout the country. What are some of the cities that you'll visit, Doctor?
Gee, Ellis, we're going next to Boston.
Boston.
Philadelphia.
And then to San Francisco, mm-hmm. Phoenix, Dallas,
Tampa. Miami.
Oh, all over.
Well, isn't that great?
Yeah.
Dr. Novello, I can understand how Faye is a real counterpart for you in these lectures.
Yes, it's really a piece of teamwork that we're trying to put together here. Alice represents so much of my message. Mm-hmm. Really, the message that I'm trying to get across, in a sense, is Alice Faye. Mm-hmm. You can prepare for older age if you plan ahead. 25% of our population in the year 2000 is going to be over the age of 65. We better, all of us younger people, begin preparing. Alice began dieting, she began exercising. She happens to have a chronic illness, but she follows doctor's orders. Mm-hmm. About 50% of elderly people do not follow doctor's orders. Did you know that? I didn't know that until I started researching this. What happens? They get a prescription, they either don't take enough of the medicine, they start feeling better, they put it away, or they take too much.
Right.
If one pill makes me feel good, two pills will make me feel better. And another thing that elderly people do more often than others is that they will swap medication. Somebody says, oh, you have a pain right there. Well, I happen to have a tablet. If I gave you a tablet for that pain,
you
friend,
wouldn't dare.
And she wouldn't take it, would she?
No,
but, you know, I wouldn't. I don't even like to take it when the doctors give it to me.
Yeah, but I hope you do.
If I know I have to, of course, you know that I would.
Yeah.
But I think so many people make the mistake of imagining they have something, too. If they read a medical column and say, by George, I bet that's what I have,
right.
Instead of really finding out.
Right. The key is to use your physician, your pharmacist, as a partner in your health care. The elder person has to ask questions. You've got to get the answers from your physician. What's wrong? Why is it wrong? What are we going to do about it?
Right.
Make sure you get all the facts, just as Alice does with her
personal
physician.
I found another thing that some of them do. They forget to take their medicine. Maybe they should take something in the morning, something at noon or something. They forget to take a few pills.
Mm-hmm.
They take them all at once when they remember.
Now, that's a particular problem. The average elder patient takes between 3 and 7 medications every day. Now, that's hard enough for anyone to follow.
Yes.
How do you handle that? One of the ways, of course, is to write it down. Make sure you know what you're taking and why, and write it down. Check it off each day after you've taken the tablets.
I do.
Well, I would have to if I were on that kind of a program.
Of course.
Particularly when you're traveling. You have to be very careful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I know that people, I think, are giving more attention to the fact that when they travel, they should keep, if there's any medication that they are committed to take, that they carry it with them as against putting it
That's
in
right.
luggage.
That's
because
what I
it
do.
Couldn't
I carry it right with me.
Wind up in Brussels as easily
as
St. Louis.
That's right. And it's important to periodically also sit down with your physician and review just what it is that you're taking.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, you know, we start getting prescriptions and you start collecting them, and all of a sudden you find out that you're taking two medications under different names that are for the same thing. It can easily happen when you're taking so much medication.
And if you travel, it's a real problem in a foreign country. I remember I was over to Europe once for 3 months, and I forgot to take my vitamins, and I feel
well,
I need vitamins.
Well, that's not too bad. No.
And I tried
really
to get,
trouble.
To get what I thought was right for me over there. It was in France, and I had a real problem.
Sure, they probably have it, but it goes under a different name, and it's hard to make that translation and to find a physician. Physicians, another thing.
And you know, if you're used to taking vitamins, whether you need them or not now. If you're used to taking them and you rely on them and you think they're good for you and you find yourself in a strange place without them for a week, you start imagining things.
Well, that's right. You start developing symptoms.
Right.
I was going to comment, Tony, on the fact that about only 1 of 10 elderly people actually have their own personal physician. Again, I learned this in my research. And one of the things that Alice and I want to stress is the need to find a personal physician that you trust, that you respect, that you can work with as a partner, and continue to keep that communication open about all of these things we're talking about.
And if you're on a program of prescribed medicine, I think it's important to establish a relationship with your pharmacist.
Yes.
And I know that it's important because there's a small pharmacy, which I go, highly recommended one, and qualified pharmacy. And never does anyone pick up a prescription from any one of the pharmacists there that he or she is not fully advised what it's for, what to expect, and what to do if there are any reverse things happening. And I think that's very valuable. Instead of just going and waiting in line to get a prescription filled, know that, the person.
That's excellent. Again, I only wish that there were more pharmacists like that, more physicians like that. Pfizer Pharmaceuticals is, of course, sponsoring this tour. They believe that the elderly must participate in a team effort, the doctor, the pharmacist, Fran, the physician, and the elderly person himself, or herself.
That's right.
They're responsible for making all of this happen, too.
Well, I'm sure you'll be talking about that as you go around the country, and we'll be back in just a few minutes to go into a little greater detail about what I think is just a wonderful tour. We'll be right back.
Never in a million years could there be another you. I would shed a million tears if ever we were through. Never in here's the key to my heart, but don't lose it. Use it.
Welcome back to Prime Time. And I guess you know, unless you just tuned in, I'm sorry, Alice, that we are visiting with Dr. Joseph DeVello and one of the loveliest stars of all motion picture history, Alice Faye.
Thank you, Fran.
Well, we're just so happy
and they're doing
have
a tour on aging, aren't you?
Yeah.
And the population is aging, isn't it, Dr. DeVello?
Well, yes. Currently, the population of people 65 and over is about 11%. But by the year 2000, one out of four Americans is going to be 65 or older.
How can the aging senior keep a better quality of life?
Well, I don't know. I think if they would, if they were just a little bit more responsible for themselves, and like we talked about, taking medications and watching their diets and maybe doing a little exercise, walking a little bit, dancing a little bit, you know, singing a little, something. You've got to do something. You've got to move.
Keep busy, huh?
Right. That's what I think.
Doctor, are there some rather common illnesses that our elderly population have or imagine they have?
Well, the big four, Fran, for the elderly are diabetes, arthritis, hypertension, which affects about 40% of all people over 65, and depression, which is the great masquerader. It can wear many faces, and the depression in the elderly is something that we're going to be talking about as we make our tour around the country, particularly among those four.
I think the fact that there are so many wonderful senior centers where they can be together with people of their own age bracket or close to that. And there's always something for them to do there if they'll just take advantage of it. And I think as they become more acquainted with it, I think they will, don't you?
Well, I think so. You know, Alice, again, is such a marvelous example for that. We talk about being active, and that's more than just physical activity. It's mental activity, contributing, making a contribution to your community. Alice goes out on a tour around the country. This isn't easy. It's
grueling. I know it isn't.
And yet she's doing it, and she's educating people. She's reaching out. There are many Alice Fays in your audience. They can do it in their own communities.
That's wonderful.
When you're at home, Alice, are your days pretty busy?
Oh, they're very busy. I mean, my days are, I can't find enough time to do things. It's really, it's very important that you keep doing things, walking, swimming, and you always have time.
I think it's just such a wonderful thing not to have time on one's hands, to be constantly wanting to have more hours in which to occupy oneself. It's so much better than in getting up and saying, what am I going to do today?
That's what most women do, don't they?
And it's a, that's a sad situation.
That's what the teenagers complain about. It's boring.
Right.
There's nothing to do.
We try to keep seniors very busy on our program here. We're always recommending different programs. Go to the senior center, be a volunteer, join a group, you know. be active. Know what you're going to do tomorrow.
That's
before
right.
you go to bed,
That's
so you have something planned. By the way, many seniors are very old and they have younger doctors. Do they question the treatment that's being given to them very often?
Yes, they do, as a matter of fact. You know, it's an interesting thing. We all tend to have doctors all through our lives who are older than we are.
Mm-hmm.
As you get elderly, however,
changes.
That's less and less possible. And I found that, for example, in my own practice, my older patients kind of look at me. They know my father, you see, and mm-hmm. they may have related to him, and he retired. And so they sometimes will call him on the phone. Doctor, I saw the young doctor there. Now, he prescribed these white pills. Is that okay? And they trust him. And I have to learn that. Younger doctors have to learn that, too, so that these things are brought out and discussed, and it's no problem if that happens.
What are some good sources for health education for seniors?
Well, there are a number of things. The kind of thing that we're doing, our lecture tour around the country, we hope helps. There are resources in the senior citizen centers throughout the country. Your own private physician, get one if you don't have one, your own private physician. Friend, you were mentioning the local pharmacist. Excellent. Alice, what other sources would you suggest? Reading, maybe?
Well, you mean
for
exercising?
Healthcare,
swimming, stretching.
And doing what comes naturally.
You know, Alice, I think that a lot of people who are taking advantage of what senior centers have to offer are finding that they can do things they never really didn't know they could do. Maybe they didn't have time to
and
do
you know
it.
They feel much better when they exercise.
I'm sure
I do.
Well,
I mean,
my
whole attitude changes, mm-hmm. and that's what's important, attitude.
We have had some people visit us on the show who maybe always had a bent for doing a certain thing in the field of arts and creative handwork of some kind, mm-hmm. and didn't have the opportunity nor the time to do it. And now they're really into it. And they have exhibits that are just fabulous.
Marvelous.
I'd have to do it by the numbers, Alice. That's
well,
the only way.
I've done it by the numbers.
Have you?
And that's great. And needlepoint is great.
Well, needlepoint is wonderful. Nice. And men are getting into that. And I think that would be a great thing for anyone who might be thinking his hands weren't as active as they had been or mm-hmm. could be.
There are so many ways to contribute. And you know, our elderly citizens better contribute. As I was saying, one of four Americans is going to be over 65. You know, we better find ways to tap this resource for not only individuals' needs, but for the health of the nation, mm-hmm. too. That's why we think this tour that we're doing is an important one. There's a changing dynamic in our nation. Your program, for example, so popular here. Why? You have a wide viewership of people mm-hmm. who relate to the things that you're saying. This kind of program is relatively new, isn't it? You're finding
yes,
an audience
I think
out
so.
There.
Yeah. But Tony has said so many times that we hope that we will have among our viewers young people, maybe young people
That's
who
true.
Are just getting married and maybe they just are thinking not beyond tomorrow or next Wednesday, but maybe it might be brought to their attention that this would not be a bad time to start planning.
No.
Or they might have parents who are becoming about the age of retirement, and mm-hmm. maybe they haven't been as fortunate as some people in being able to prepare for their future. Mm-hmm. But if we can alert young people to the fact that planning yes. is a very important thing,
yeah, that's right.
we will have accomplished
very
something.
True.
Yeah, and your tour is going to do that. You'll
so.
Have
we
many younger
so.
People looking, and they need to learn as much as they can to help their parents and their elderly
yes,
relatives,
true.
You know.
No question.
And you have so many fans. That
I'm looking forward to seeing a lot of them.
Really?
I see
this
show is on three times in a week, and the first show that people see, they'll be telling everybody about it, and the audience will grow each day.
Well,
I don't know whether we should keep Tony on in the capacity in which he now is working, or whether he should be a PR man, because he knows all the angles,
does he?
Well, with age comes such knowledge.
Right. Maybe. Anyway, we certainly are happy to have had you here today, and
Thank you, friend.
The very best for you in your tour, because we know how valuable you can be to the many people you will reach. And you might just send us a picture postal card along the way.
We will.
And let us know how you're doing.
Very nice of you.
We're
going to
try real hard.
Thank you, Doctor, and thank you, lovely Alice.
Thank you so much. Thanks, friend.
And we'll be right back in just a few minutes.
Here's the key to my heart, but don't lose it. Use it. Come on up and drink a loving cup, but don't abuse it. Step right into my heart. It's so roomy, gloomy. Come and bring a little song of spring and sing it to me. There's a million hugs and kisses wasting away on the shelf. What an opportunity this.
Tony, wasn't it just great having Alice Faye here and Dr. Novello?
It's a wonderful thing that they're doing, lecturing on aging. We need that.
Yes, because everyone is aging.
Right.
And they're giving so willingly of their time.
Yes, and such prominent people can attract a lot of attention, and the word spreads.
Well, you should know, because you certainly give of your time.
Well, I enjoy it.
I know you do. Well, we have certainly enjoyed being with you today, and we'll look forward to having you join us again, and that very soon. Thank you for now. See you soon.